43
एक में 42 दिया हुआ है।
हाँ 42 दिया है क्योंकि वो आंध्रा का दो हो गया पहले एक
So before we start our today's press conference on celebration of 150 years of birth anniversary of Swami Vivekananda, I would like to introduce the key members of the celebration committee in the state level. So here on the dais is Sri Navam Atum, kindly stand up, President Celebration Committee, Sri Navam Atum. Then next is Dr. Jaram Beggi, National Member of Celebration Committee and Prant Pramukh Vivekananda Kendra Itanagar. Next is Mr. Rinchin Murthy, Prant Sanjayak Organizing Committee. And the fourth is Dr. Tejum Padu, Sir Prant Pramukh Vivekananda Kendra. Then next is Sri Pritam Tafo, Secretary of Celebration Committee, and myself is Publicity Secretary, Celebration Committee. So after the introduction of the key members of the Celebration Committee members, there will be a PowerPoint presentation on various activities of year-long celebration of 150th birth anniversary of Swami Vivekananda across the country.
So we'll show you what we are going to do in this 150th birthday celebration of Swami Vivekananda through a PowerPoint presentation. You can see on the screen, this is because 150th birth anniversary of Swami Vivekananda. It will be a year-long program, not program for a day. It will be a year-long program. So the theme is Wake Up Bharat, Enlighten the World. This is the theme. Next. So I did not introduce about Swami Vivekananda. He was great disciple of Ramakrishna and Hindu missionary, a patriot, and who took the message about great India to the foreign country. The main objective of the celebration, you can see on the screen, is to give universal message of Bharat, oneness, and respect of diversity and immortality of soul in the words of Swami Vivekananda to as many as possible. This is the main objectives of the celebration. So we have now, next we have arranged this celebration to in a category of geographical arrangement. You can see on the screen, we have, next, we have 11 zones and 43 units, 960 districts and 4 lakh villages. In this celebration, we will be in, you can see 11 zones, we will be covering all the states of India. There will be 11 zones, 43 units and 960 districts and 4 lakh villages will be celebrating this year-long program of 150th birth anniversary of Swami Vivekananda. So next is how the celebration will be done. This is the organization arrangement of this our celebration. First will be Ayojan Samitis, there is a working committee. There will be two kind of Samitis, one is working committee and one is Samarao Samiti. Samarao means celebration committee, there will be celebration committee and there will be working committees. So two categories we have divided to celebrate this one. So you can see 43 units and 960 districts, this units have been made. 5 segments. Next is we have to celebrate this. We have prepared 5 IAMs, means the segments. You can next. Before that, I think. Okay, it's all right. This you can see, this is the national programs we will be celebrating this year now. Sankalp Divas will be on 25th December 2012. And on the 12th January, we will be taking out a procession. This is Shobha Yatra. This is on the birth day celebrations on the 12th January. And on 8th February, we will have Samuhik Surya Namaskar. That means we will be organizing Surya Namaskar in mass manner. And for Griha Sampark, we will be going to the house and house, contact with people. And our target is 4 crore house we have targeted to reach and contact with people. And 5th will be, there will be a mini marathon. That's a Bharat Jago Daud. Next. So there will be, as I said, there will be 5 segments. This is IAMS, 5 segments. The one will be first Yuva Shakti. That's to youth power for participation and channelize youth power. And second would be Pravuddha Bharat, where engaging our elites and intellectuals to help build a nation. And third will be Gramayans, that's a contributions village and support them in integral development. Samvardhi, this is, as you have seen, this is regarding the taking along the women with us in part. So third is, five is Asmita. This is a respect, preserve and protect the practice of indigenous faith and culture. This is the 5 segments we have decided, we have kept in this year-long celebration. So, in this IAMS, in the segments, there's a, in Yuva Shakti, Vivekananda Yuva Swadhyay Mandal, study circle will be there, essay competition, Yuva Sammelan, youth, that one, Sammelan, in Angreshi we can
Conference, youth conference.
And it's the Bharat Jago Daud, run for the nation, and Seva Sapta. This is to go into the villages, the state level seminars, national level seminars will also be there. And this celebration will not be, national seminars will be there. And we have the seminars of vice chancellors also in these villages. We will have tehsil level conferences, and we will. Swamiji's pictures at village, panchayat, schools, temples, library, etc. We will place these pictures and we celebrate village Gramotsav, Bharat Mata Pujan, programs, Kathatar, Kirtankar, folk artists. Because this is not here in Arunachal Pradesh, but in other states, Kirtankars and Kathakars, they will be singing the about the life of Swami Vivekananda. And we will have programs for women of the villages. Next is, as I said, Samvardhini. Here we will have Sammelan for young couples. We will have conferences for young couples, Shakti Sammelans, there are Sammelans of women. Kishori Vikas Shivir, this is for young girls. Lectures, workshops, and enhanced participation of women in the national regeneration. Because, as I said earlier, women plays a very important role. So, in that, Samvardhini, all these programs would be there. And next, we have Asmita. This is more particularly regarding the culture, indigenous faith, etc. Promote that one. So, Janjati Sammelans, exhibition, sale of Janjati products, that village, Gramotsav, that will be there. Sports, traditional dance competitions, medical camps, and planting of trees. This would be the compulsory programs we will have. Apart from this also, we will be having other programs also. This is the compulsory programs that we will be doing in this year-long program. Works of Swami Vivekananda in the local languages also, that is important lectures is given by Swami Vivekananda. Books which have been completed, Swami Vivekananda Life and Messages, English has been completed. Bharat Jago, Vishwa Jago, that books is there. Yugnaya Marathi, that is Sarna Lata Vishikar. Swami Vivekananda and Dr. Ambedkar Marathi, that books has been completed. Rousing Call to Hindu Nation. And books for mass circulation, Swami Vivekananda Life and Messages, important messages of Swami Vivekananda. And the message Bharat Jago, Vishwa Jago, this is the main message with which we are celebrating this 150th birth anniversary. And of course, the last, one of the most important part is the collection of fund for this celebration. So how we are going to raise the fund, this is the small that we have given. First, there will be 150 rupees coupon. So we will try to sell, because it's minimum amount. I think many of people all over India can afford this one to contribute for the celebration. And second, through we will be having receipts of 150 rupees. And one is through receipts. That will be receipt giving. That's 10,000 and above. This and of course through we will be seeking sponsors. For books, t-shirts, etc. for that we will be using for year-long program. So this is, and lastly, this program will culminate in the 20th January 2014. This is all the programs that I have said. This will, 12th January 2014, this celebration will, year-long celebration will end. And by April, we will dissolve this Rajya Samaroh Samiti, that's a celebration committee. That's the program we have for this 150th birthday. That's all. I'd
like to request Sri to give a little bit of highlights to media so that they can carry out the message to lengthen Britain.
Joram Begin, Ram Pramukh Vivekananda Center, Ajin Padu, Convener BKIC, Mr. Rinchin Bodhi, Mr. Kodi to Vivekananda Center, Mujhe Isse 150 ईयर्स डिवोशन का अजब रूप से मुझे चुना गया है, तो इसके लिए मुझे दिल्ली में बुलाया चार दिसंबर को। मैंने वहाँ का जो सेंट्रल कमेटी के साथ में एक दिन मीटिंग बैठ कर आया है। ये एक बहुत ही हमारे देश के लिए एक बहुत बड़ा दिन है। स्वामी विवेकानंद उनके बारे में ज़्यादा मेरा कोई यानी जानकारी तो नहीं है, लेकिन जो कुछ मैं जानता हूँ वो एक देशभक्ति जिसने इस भारतवर्ष का, इस हिंदुस्तान का स्थान को विश्व के शीर्ष रूप में पहुँचा के आया, ऊँचा स्थान में पहुँचा के आने वाले एक महान व्यक्ति, उनके बारे में आज हम एक साल जन्म दिवस को एक साल मनाने के हम लोग अभी जाने वाले हैं। हमने दिल्ली में देखा है, पूरे प्रदेश के स्टेट का जो अध्यक्ष और सेंट्रल कमिटी के जितना भी मेंबर है सब लोग वहाँ आए विवेकानंद इंटरनेशनल फाउंडेशन हॉल में। मैंने देखा कि इतना विद्वान लोग, बड़े बड़े विद्वान लोग वहाँ इसी काम में लगे हुए हैं। जैसे हमारा लोकसभा का जो सेक्रेटरी जनरल और चीफ ऑफ दी आर्मी का जो चीफ ऑफ द आर्मी स्टाफ रिटायर्ड चीफ जस्टिस रिटायर्ड, ऐसे ऐसे बड़े बड़े लोगों ने सेंट्रल कमेटी में, यानी ये स्वामी विवेकानंद श्रद्धा शक्ति समारोह में भागीदारी बनकर उन लोग काम कर रहे हैं। उन लोगों को देख के हम भी बहुत दिल में अच्छा लगा। और ऐसे बड़े लोगों के सामने हमने साथ में बैठकर बात करने को मौका मिला, इसलिए मैं अपने आप को बहुत सौभाग्य मानता हूँ। मेरे तरफ से खास ऐसे आपको कुछ बोलने का तो नहीं है, जो भी बोलना चाहे जो भी चीज़ मेरे मुझे इतना मालूम तो नहीं है, लेकिन जो भी कुछ है आपका नोट में प्रेस नोट में पूरा दिया गया है। तो मेरा भी एक अपील है कि स्वामी विवेकानंद का जो आइडियोलॉजी को लेके इन्हें जो भारत जगो दुनिया को जगाओ वाक बारो इनलाइटन वर्ल्ड, ये जो आइडिया जो उन्होंने लेके हमारे देश में, हमारा हिंदुस्तान में, भारतवर्ष में जो मैसेज छोड़ते गए हैं, जो इन्हें वाणी छोड़ते गए, उस चीज को जो संदेश देके गए, उस चीज उस संदेश को हमें इस वन ईयर सेलिब्रेशन में पूरा करने का कोशिश करना चाहिए। और जितना हो सके मुझे बताया गया कि प्रदेश लेवल में, जो डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल में, सेंट्रल लेवल में, सब डिविजन लेवल में, हर क्षेत्र में कमिटी बनाया गया है। ये कमिटी को हमें आगे ले जाना होगा और जिस कमिटी के द्वारा स्वामी जी का जो मैसेज को गांव-गांव में पहुंचा सके, विशेषकर जो हमारा आने वाले जो यूथ युवक युवती के बीच में इस मैसेज को लेके जाना है, इसके लिए इस प्रदेश के जो कमेटी है, हमारे कमेटी मेंबर्स लोग, आप सबको, हम तो ऐसे एक इल हेल्थ आदमी है लेकिन हम आपके साथ में हैं। मैं आशा करता हूँ आप सब उस कार्य को लेकर तन मन धन से आगे बढ़ेंगे, तो मैं आशा करता हूँ। और साथ साथ हमारे जो प्रदेश के जो ये प्रदेश के जो विवेकानंद समिति के अध्यक्षगण हैं, मेंबरगण हैं, ये सब हम उनको साथ देंगे, ये आशा करता हूँ। लेकिन ये बार जो इस बार जो सेलिब्रेशन है इसमें कोई विवेकानंद केंद्र का सेलिब्रेशन नहीं है, ये पूरे देश के लोगों का सेलिब्रेशन है। हमने दिल्ली में मालूम हुआ कि उसमें इवन मुस्लिम, सिख, ईसाई सब लोग उसमें साथ देने वाला है। और देश भर में जितना भी ये देश सेवा के लिए, समाज सेवा के लिए जो कार्य करने वाले जितना भी संगठन है, ये सब साथ देने वाले हैं। तो ये बहुत बड़ा एक इवेंट है, बहुत बड़ा एक सेलिब्रेशन है। इवन फॉरेन कंट्री में भी सेलिब्रेशन होने जा रहे हैं। और हमारा सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, जो ये केंद्र सरकार और राज्य सरकार भी उसको ठीक से सेलिब्रेशन करने, अच्छा से सेलिब्रेशन करने के लिए मोहर लगा चुका है। तो इसलिए ये बहुत बड़ा इवेंट है और सब लोग उसको ध्यान में रखते हुए अपना अपना कार्य को, अपना अपना रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी को आगे लेके जाना।
president of celebration committee. Now, next, I would like to request Dr. Jalam Begi, the national member of celebration committee, as well as the Prant Pramukh Vivekananda Kendra, to give a little bit of about the celebration of our 150th Prata Yosef Swami Kalanda to our press fraternity.
Sri Atum Ji, Rijin Dorji Ji, Tejun Padu Ji, our colleagues and media friends. Well, you have heard Atumji, who is our president of the state organizing committee, about the plan. And before that, Advocate Pritam Tapoji has given you in detail what are the preparation that is being made in the nation level and the state level. And also, as Atumji says, that I think this has been circulated already. So kindly go through the details for your coverage. But having said that, I thought, you know this Swami Vivekananda, it's needless to make mention the importance of the person, that his impact to the Indian culture, to the Indian nation, and even to the world. So this, everybody, I can say that maybe a scientist, maybe a very good politician, maybe a very good administrator, is being influenced by the vision, the idea of Swamiji. And more importantly, I may say so, I said elsewhere, that recently I visited one country called Guatemala. And you people might be knowing about the Mayan culture and the Mayan civilization. That is in Guatemala, Mexico, in this Central America, that was very famous. But not much has been known to the world, as we know about the Egyptian civilization, the Chinese civilization, for that matter, Indian civilization. The reason is that this Mayan civilization, I have seen the pyramids. They had also, like we know about the Egyptian pyramids, but not the Mayan pyramids. But this time I have seen the Mayan pyramids as tall as almost 300 feet tall pyramids. In one area alone, there are 38 temples. And every temple has a huge complex. Being from Arunachal, I would like to say, the temple number one is the sun temple, and temple number two is the moon temple, which is, having some kind of a similarity with us. So like that, in one area alone, 38 temples, I couldn't see all. I've seen four or five only. But what I mean to say is that there are so many other places that this Mayan civilization could be called the Great Mayan Civilization. But then, that is little known now. Why? That is, that when Columbus discovered America, the whole of Western Hemisphere, in fact, they wanted to discover India. There is a story, it goes like this, that when Galileo for the first time proved that you know, Earth is not flat. Before, people believe, used to believe that Earth is flat, but Galileo proved that Earth is not flat, it is round. So Marco Polo was the first time that from Europe traveled to India and landed in Calicut. And he returned with a huge kind of thing, cargo. He became the richest man. Then Columbus thought that since Earth is you know, round, Marco Polo has gone to us the east. You know, Marco Polo meant you know, round the world, not it was this who landed Columbus, this is not Marco Polo is the earlier one who made the round the world.
Magellan.
No, not Magellan. This Goa and all, India, he came. Vasco da Gama. When the Vasco da Gama returned a huge cargo, then all of Europe become famous of the Indian whale. So everybody was attracted to come to India and take wealth back, trade with India. So Columbus thought that Vasco da Gama has gone towards the east and reached India, so he can go towards the west and still can reach India. So he went towards the west and discovered America. And then that is why all these people are called Indians, Red Indians. They're actually not there because of India, they are being called as India. So here, since Columbus discovery and the Spaniards occupied this Guatemala, and after occupation of Guatemala, they made that the European culture is superior to the Mayan culture. They are all Mayan practices, they are all Mayan belief as inferior, and every one of them forcibly converted to Christianity. And because of that, the Mayan people lost their everything. Even their civilization buried under earth. Still excavations are on. See, there are some mounds. People thought these are mountains, but these are the, you know, when digging you find there are pyramids. This is the situation. Because it's a tropical jungle, it is all overgrown. So what I mean to say, that had Swami Vivekananda been not there, and especially that the World Religious Conference of 1893, he pleaded that the Indian religion, the Indian culture, and Indian as a whole are not inferior to any other religion, any other culture, any other people. And since then only the West recognized the greatness of India, Indian literature, Indian history. So this is, he is the person who is my man. And today we call that Mahatma Gandhi or many others. They have struggled, got the freedom and all. Okay, physically, we don't deny that Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru or many others, they really did it. But the spirit behind, you need somebody to empower to spirit. So this is the forerunner of that united Indian thinking, the real sense of patriotism. That comes from the culture, that comes from the you know, spiritual belief of the people. So that has been given by Swami Vivekananda. So that is why his thinking, today religion people are calling, his you know, or kind of you know, interpretation of religion is also altogether different. That becomes the universal religion, acceptable to all. Like Garidra Narayan. If time permits, I'll talk you a little bit. You know, once after you know coming back from this Chicago, Swami Vivekananda became very famous. There was I don't remember exactly, Rupesh, you will help me out. One famous journalist of that time, like you, one of you, had come to see Swami Vivekananda. And that journalist was accompanied by one eminent gentleman from Punjab. Now that Punjabi gentleman wanted to know something about the spirituality, religion, or something like philosophy. That the moment both of them came to Swami Vivekananda, introduced himself that he is from Punjab. Swami Vivekananda was so much interested on the problem of Punjab, because by the time it was pre-independent, a dangerous famine was going on in Punjab. So he started asking how people are suffering and what are the arrangements being made and what could be the solution, how can we help. He kept on talking almost 1 hour, how to solve it, and this famine not only is the Punjab case, but Bengal also, elsewhere, Maharashtra also, it can happen and it is happening, how to settle it out. He was deeply involved in it. Then they got the time for interview only 1 hour. The time was over. Then at the time of departure, said thank you very much each other. That Punjabi was very much dissatisfied. Then they said, what happened? He said, Swamiji, we came here to know about the religion, the spirituality of India. But today we couldn't hear anything from you. We all talked about this famine and all. Then Swamiji said that, look here, if a single dog, a street dog in India is starving, or a poor man's hut is without, his kitchen is not lighted, it's no point of talking about religion. It is better we are to talk about the problem, that is the Daridra Narayan. And that is why today we call this archmission as their motto, saying service to men is service to God. So like that, this kind of inspiration, even any problem of today, the solution, if you read Swami Vivekananda, that it has a solution. He has prescribed, and that he has made and dreamt for this future of the country. And his vision is also, when he talked about that this will be realized after 1500 years. So everywhere, if you write many of his figure, that 150 or 00 are important because of his vision. So that is why this is 150th anniversary of Swami Vivekananda, that going to take place in India, not only in India. Again, I may so say so that when in America, I visited talked about and met the address certain forums, Hindu communities. Everywhere this preparation is on. American Indians also, they have constituted national level some committees for the celebration of this 150th birth anniversary of Swami Vivekananda. So it is throughout the celebration. And again, for your information, I'm again a member of National Committee, Advisory Committee of RK Mission also. So government of India is also taking up the Swami Vivekananda's this 150th birth anniversary very seriously. I think there is one television program through Doordarshan on every Tuesday probably at about 10. I think some of you should look at that. And besides that, they have met I think 300 crore or so for this celebration earmark. And out of that, 200 crore has been given Arc Mission. Arc Mission is the real nodal agency because, as you know, Arc Mission is the child of again Swami Vivekananda. So they have been given, and Arc Mission is also making huge, you know, nationwide, worldwide preparation for this. So here, my appeal to the people through you would be that we should also take it up, Arunachal Pradesh should also take it up very seriously. And as far as Arunachal Pradesh is concerned, it's more relevant. As Pritam Tapaji has made the five segments, all the segments are important. But the last segment is Mita, no? Asmita is very much relevant to us. After going through the world, but we need Arunachal Pradesh is still, you know, many things to be said. Other people have lost everything. So that is why that ethnic community, indigenous people, or through maybe a festival, or through maybe a documentation. So this, you know, through the celebration of Swamiji's 150th anniversary, we can, you know, take up this thing. And same is the case, the other side, the first one, I'm talking about last one and the first one. The first one, youth. As you know, that the youth in the state has sometimes become restless, maybe for many reasons. But one of the reasons we know that they are not being properly motivated. They are not being properly guided. So therefore, the youth may be straying. And as you know, our future is dependent on the students and youth. Our youth, if they are straying, if they are deviating from their path, if they are not properly guided, if they are not properly motivated, our future may be bleak. And I know Arunachal Pradesh is passing through a transitory period as far as the development is concerned. But at the same time, the transitory period is a very strategic period also. It's a, you know, important time period. So it needs to be guided properly. We are worried for this. We every day through your reports, we come to know that this thing is happening, that thing is happening, you know, kind of this organization, that organization. So our youth need to be properly educated, properly guided. Probably Swamiji's 150th celebration through Yuva that month or so, it will be, you know, opportunity for us to take care of our youth. So therefore, my appeal would be the participation of all the people of Arunachal Pradesh, including government of Arunachal Pradesh, and also the other NGOs. As Atumji has rightly said, that this is not only, you know, celebration done by any particular community or a particular organization like Vivekananda Kendra organization. It's kind of a people's movement. So everybody is participating in it. So Arunachal should not lag behind. And we should also join with the nation. This is my report. Thank you.
For giving very informative feedback to our media friends, including his lot of experience gained during his recent visit to the foreign countries, and giving so much of information regarding Swami Vivekananda. So thank you very much for him. And now I would request Mr. Rinchin Dorjee, the Prant Pramukh, to say something to our media.
के जो लोग यहाँ पर आसम लगे थे, वैसे आप कुछ कहने को नहीं रह गया, क्योंकि पूरा आपका जो प्रेजेंटेशन जो आपको दिया है उसमें भी पूरा कवर हुआ है। फिर अतुल जी और बेबी जी का जो भाषण से आपको पूरा क्लियर हुआ है। मैं थोड़ा सा वेकअप भारत और इनलाइटेंड वर्ल्ड पर थोड़ा सा जोड़ देना चाहूँगा। जब हम वेकअप भारत का बात करता है तो अभी जो भारत, इस समय जो भारत है उसको जगाने का बात नहीं करता है। मैं जहाँ तक समझता हूँ, ये जो हमारा प्राचीन भारत को जगाने की कोशिश करता है, जिस प्राचीन भारत को विश्व गुरु के रूप से मानते थे, तो उस समय पर उनका जो वैल्यू सिस्टम था, जो उनका कल्चर था, उनका ट्रेडिशन, तो वो जो है पूरा विश्व में फैलता था। अब धीरे धीरे आधुनिक युग में हमको देखने को मिलता है कि जब हम पूरा हमको जो भौतिक सुख पूरा मिलना शुरू हो जाता है, तो धीरे धीरे हमारा जो आध्यात्मिक जो चीज़ें हैं वो हम भूलने लगते हैं। हमारा आकर्षण जो बाहर बाहर के जो सुंदर चीज है उन पर लगता है, और हम रियलिटी और जो अपीयरेंस उसका जो बीच का जो फर्क को हम नहीं समझ पाते हैं। जब हम जगत गुरु जब कहते हैं, तो आप छोटा सा एग्जाम्पल मैं दूंगा कि जो आज बुद्धिज्म का बात बोलिए, बुद्धिज्म पूरा दुनिया में फैला हुआ है, उसका गुरु कहाँ है? गुरु भारत है। भारत में बुद्धिज्म का जन्म हुआ है, आज पूरा विश्व भर में जो है वो फैला। इस तरह से कई एग्जाम्पल्स हैं। तो जब हम जब बात करते हैं वेकअप भारत की बात करते हैं, तो हमारा जो प्राचीन भारत है उसको जगाना है, हमारा वैल्यू सिस्टम को जगाना है, और उसको जगाते हुए हमारा अंदर में फिर वही वैल्यू को डालना है, उसको डाल करके फिर भारत पूरा दुनिया में विश्व में एक बार फिर गुरु बनने की कोशिश करना है। बाकी जितना भी आयाम है, पांच आयामों के बारे में पूरी तरह से बहुत ही अच्छी तरह से बोला है। युवा पीढ़ियों के बारे में, जो युवा शक्ति का जो बात है, उसका सही ढंग से उनका जो चैनलाइज नहीं हो रहा है, उनका सही दिशा नहीं मिल रहा है, तो उसके बारे में डॉक्टर बेबी जी ने भी कहा। इसके बारे में मैं कई बार कई जगह में जहाँ स्कूल्स है और वहाँ पर जाकर कहते आया हूँ कि जो वैल्यू एजुकेशन जो है अब पूरी तरह से हमारा भारत से चला गया है। इसका कारण जो है गुरुजनों का गलती भी नहीं है, क्योंकि इसमें जो आपका जो कैरिकुलम जो डेवलप किया है, वो इस ढंग से डेवलप किया है कि उसको जो है आगे में उसका कंपटीशन हो, उनको रोटी रोजी मिले, तो ऐसे समय पर उनको पूरा कोर्स खत्म करना पड़ता है, तो उनको जो है ये समय नहीं मिलता है कि उनको वैल्यू के बारे में उनको बताया जाए, उनका कैरेक्टर किस तरह से बिल्डअप करना चाहिए, एक जो 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 ऑलराउंड जो डेवलपमेंट कहता है, तो वो जो है डेवलप करने का मौका नहीं मिलता है। तो इसीलिए जो है आपका जो युवा शक्ति के इसमें जो अभी जो हम लोग जो जो प्रोग्राम रखा है, उस प्रोग्राम में जो है इस जो है 150वीं जयंती के माध्यम से ये कोशिश करेंगे कि उनको किस तरह से हम लोग उनको दिशा देना चाहिए, और उनके लिए किस तरह से दशा बनाना चाहिए उसका दिशा से ही देने के लिए, तो ये हम लोग जो है कोशिश करेंगे। तो इसमें जो है आपका जो है प्रेस का भी बहुत बड़ा योगदान बनता है। इसको आप जिस ढंग से प्रचार करेंगे, उस ढंग से जो है लोगों के अंदर में इम्पैक्ट पड़ेगा। इसका अलावा जो अभी जो फंड का बात है, फंड जो है अभी जो हम लोग बहुत सारे बड़ा प्रोग्राम्स का बात कर रहे हैं, जो हम ग्रामायण की बात करते हैं, अस्मिता का बात करते हैं, प्रबुद्ध भारत की बात करते हैं, संवर्धिनी के बारे में बात करता है, युवा शक्ति के बारे में बात करता है, बहुत सारे पब्लिकेशंस के बारे में बात करते हैं, लेकिन यहाँ पर फंड जो है क्रांति जो है हमेशा रहेगा, क्योंकि कहीं से भी फंडिंग जो है यो जो विवेकानंद केंद्र को कहीं से भी फंडिंग नहीं है, तो इसके लिए जो है 150 रुपया का जो कूपन जो घर घर में जो है आपका गृह संपर्क द्वारा वहां जाएंगे। इसके अलावा जो अभी आपका जो टी शर्ट्स वगैरह बिक्री होगा, बुक्स वगैरह बिक्री होगा, उनका जो है फोटोग्राफ्स वगैरह बिक्री होंगे। इसके अलावा मेरा जो भी कंस्ट्रक्शन विभाग के लोग हैं, जो भी पावर डेवलपर्स है या जितना भी एंटरप्रेनर्स है, उनसे मेरा रिक्वेस्ट होगा कि कुछ कुछ इवेंट्स जो है उनको स्पॉन्सर करना चाहिए, स्पॉन्सर करें, उनके लिए वो बैनर बनाए, बैनर के नीचे उनका अपना खुद नाम ले, जहाँ पर हमको उसको क्या कहते हैं रिसीव देना ना पड़े। हम लोगों का जो कंट्रीब्यूशन, जो हम लोग जो डोनेशन मांगेंगे, वो सिर्फ 10,000 से ऊपर ही कंट्रीब्यूशन होगा, उसका रिसीट मिलेगा। उसका नीचे जितना भी है हमारा गृह संपर्क में 150 रुपया का कूपन ही बिक्री होगा, तो उसी से हमारा कार्यक्रम चलेगा। अगर हमारा फंड कम होगा तो हमारा कार्यक्रम भी छोटा हो जाएगा। तो कार्यक्रम को बड़ा बनाने के लिए, गाँव गाँव तक पहुँचने के लिए, स्वामी जी के जो मैसेज को गाँव गाँव तक पहुँचा करके वहाँ के लोगों के अंदर में एक नया जागृति लाने के लिए, और युवा शक्ति को अपना शक्ति को सही ढंग से पहचानने के लिए, महिलाओं को अपने शक्ति को पहचानने के लिए, वो अधिक जो है योगदान समाज को ऊपर उठाने में कैसे कर सकता है, और जो आपका जो प्रबुद्ध भारत हो इंटेलेक्चुअल ग्रुप है, उनका जो है योगदान जो है हमारा राष्ट्र का निर्माण में क्या कर सकता है, तो ये सब के बारे में जो है हमको फंड का बहुत ही जरूरत पड़ेगा। तो आपका माध्यम से ये भी कोशिश होगा कि जो है 150 का जो जो आपका कूपन बिक्री होगा, या 10,000 से ऊपर का जो डोनेशन होगा, या इसके अलावा कुछ कुछ जैसे मैंने पहले कहा कुछ कुछ इवेंट्स को स्पॉन्सर करें, जैसे एक टूर्नामेंट है, जैसे एक सेमिनार है, जैसे एक खेल है, स्पोर्ट्स है, या एक कल्चर इवेंट है, ऐसे कॉम्पिटिशन है, कोई एक ग्रुप उसको स्पॉन्सर कर लेता है, तो उसके लिए ना हमको रिसीट देने की जरूरत पड़ेगा, ना कूपन बिक्री करने की जरूरत पड़ेगा। तो उनका अपना बोर्ड होगा, बोर्ड के नीचे उनका एडवर्टाइजमेंट भी हो जाएगा कि उसका ये जो है स्पॉन्सरशिप इनका है करके। तो मैं आशा करता हूँ कि जो है ये कार्यक्रम, ये जो हमारा एक साल का जो एक आयोजन होगा, जो सेलिब्रेशन होगा, तो उसमें जो है प्रेस का भी अच्छा योगदान होगा। प्रेस का माध्यम से मतलब गांव गांव तक जो आज यहाँ पर मैसेज है, आपके पास में पूरा प्रेस नोट है, और जितने भी जो रीडिंग मटेरियल्स आपके पास है, आप इसको किस सुंदर ढंग से, किस इफेक्टिव इम्पैक्ट लगा करके आप लगा सकते हैं, जिससे कि ये कार्यक्रम जो है पूरी तरह से सफल रहे और इसका इम्पैक्ट बहुत देर तक चले, ये जो है भारत निर्माण हो, अरुणाचल निर्माण हो, जो अभी कहीं कहीं बहक किया है लोग, वो जो है फिर वापस जो है मेन स्ट्रीम में आए और सही ढंग से जो है अरुणाचल को ऊपर ले जाने में, तो अपना जो कल्चर, अपना जो ट्रेडिशन, अपना को जो तलाशने का, हम कौन है, कहाँ से आया है, क्या है, और हमको क्या करना चाहिए अपना पहचान को बनाए रखने का, ये जो जो है स्वामी जी का उनसे मिल, स्वामी जी का विचारों से मिलते हुए अपना जो स्थानीय जो जो प्रॉब्लम्स है उसको सोल्व करना ही इसका जो है मेन मकसद है। धन्यवाद।
Thank you very much. Suggestions regarding the activities to be carried out during the annual celebration in Arunachal Pradesh and the national as a whole. For his information to the press and media. Now, I would also like to request Dr. Jatin Badu, Jatin Badu, Saab Khan Pramukh, to attend the presentation.
डॉक्टर जोराम बेगी जी, विंसेंट डोजी जी, अंशु जी, शर्मा जी एंड प्रेस फ्रेटर्निटी। आर्नोल्ड टॉयनबी, द ग्रेट अमेरिकन हिस्टोरियन, एंड विल डोरांट, द ग्रेट फिलोसोफर ऑफ ग्रेट ब्रिटेन, हैव रिकॉग्नाइज्ड इंडिया इज the Jagat Guru in their treatise, and Swami Vivekananda is the great guru. Many may be asking or will raise questions why to celebrate Swami Vivekananda 150th birth anniversary celebrations. It's the relevance, the universal relevance that the message of Swamiji has with us. Think of any subject, content related to mankind. He has spoken, he has written, he has given the message. Let it be on health, let it be on village life, let it be on yoga, let it be on nation building and also on education. You will find all the remedies, the special remedies through the message of Swami Vivekananda. That's why even Mahatma Gandhi said, if you want to know India, read Vivekananda. And that's very much true. When we talk of national movement, many may not be knowing Bal Gangadhar Tilak. He used to appear in the night, rode the boat to Belur Math to seek his advice. He was the inspiring soul to motivate our national movement. Go through the writings of even Netaji. He says that he was inspired. He was fired by the message of Swami Vivekananda. Talk of Anna Hazare. Anna Hazare is all being, the present existence, is a social worker, one who is working for the mass. That inspiration came to him when he read the book of Swami Vivekananda in a railway station. So that is Swamiji. And in him, we find the youth, in him we find the past, in him we find our future, in him we find our strength. And he was not ready to compromise. If anybody says that India is weak, once he was traveling, when he was traveling to America to participate in the World Conference of Religion, in the Jahaz, there was one, a white man, was cursing India, telling lot of things about India in a negative way. As we know, Swamiji had a good health. He got up, caught hold of both the persons, picked them up, was about to throw them in the sea. They begged apology and he pardoned them. That was Swamiji. When he talks of be bold, he physically experienced that. When he was traveling through Varanasi, he was chased by monkeys. Initially, he was also feeling afraid. You know, monkeys are always notorious. He ran for some time, some steps, but something got into his soul, into him. He stood, faced the monkeys, and the monkeys ran back. That was the inspiration. Be bold, face the world, face the problems. Now, one by one, there are some quotations of Swamiji based on which we have made it a point to move ahead these 150th celebrations, which in fact starts from respecting our own culture, ourselves. I would like to quote, "I do not see into the future, nor do I care to see, but one vision I see clear as life before me, that the ancient mother has awakened once more. Sitting on her throne, rejuvenated, more glorious than ever, proclaim her to all the world with the voice of peace and veneration. So mother is the country, the India, which we need to respect, and also our own culture. And he further says on our fate, the youth. My youth is in the younger generation, the modern generation. Out of them will come my workers. They will work out the whole problem like lions. This is one of the main targets why we need to remember him. In 1988, in Belur Mot, an international youth convention was organized. That was purely for youth. But then to make youth to build India. And such celebrations that we are having today is also a continuity of the same spirit that we need to awaken India through Swamiji. Loving our ancestors, loving our culture. He speaks, when a man has begun to be ashamed of his ancestors, the end has come. Here am I, one of the least of Hindu race, yet proud of my race, proud of my ancestors. I am proud to call myself a Hindu. I am proud that I am one of your unworthy servants. I am proud that I am a countryman of yours. You, the descendants of the sages, you, the descendants of the most glorious rishis the world ever saw, is to respect yourself, your past, your ancestors. And he says, the alone live, who live for others, the rest are more dead than alive. We may follow any religion, but we need to think for the mankind. That is Swamiji. And through such celebrations, what exactly we want? We want the evaluation of the positive thinking, the evaluation of the generations who will be working for the nation, for the world in a positive way. He says, elevation of the masses without injuring their religion, respecting other religion. And also, he says that there should not be any kind of disintegration in the nation. We talk of so many things. We are ready to build many states. We are ready to communalize our society. But for him, there should be one union, one thought, one message for unity of the country. He says, nation union in India must be a gathering up of its scattered spiritual forces, pro-religion, pro-spiritual. A nation in India must be a union of those whose hearts beat to the same spiritual tune. What is the tune? Tune of union. Singing for the union of India. Singing for the betterment of India. So these are few of his quotes. And Swami Vivekananda, as we have seen, as you have learned, will continue to be our inspiring souls, not for India, for the whole nation. And not only that, inspired by him, there are many Swamijis from foreign countries, they have joined. And I met one Japanese who has become a Swamiji. Even I met one IAS officer who has become a Swamiji in the Belur Mot. After getting IAS, he joined a Swamiji. one MBBS. After becoming a doctor, he left and joined as Swamiji. What are these? These are the inspirations. And the inspirations that bring people to build India. So let us try to popularize, give more publicity in the essence of Swami Vivekananda, in the essence of India, for the universal feelings, for universal livelihood, so that we live as one family, as in the Sanskrit it is says, Vasundhara Kutumbakam. Thank you.
Today I stand here not as a director IPR, I stand here as a publicity secretary of the celebration committee. And all these members, I have not mentioned about their designations. They are the executive members of core committee of the celebration, this thing, 150th years of anniversary celebration of Swami Vivekananda. Now, we have organized this press conference to give you some feedback, to give you some tips that how we will go about the celebration, whole year celebration. That is from 12th January, coming January, to the next 14th January. After Dr. Paduji has mentioned about the message to the world. Now we are to live in communal harmony, we are to live in unity. And we are to, you know, build a nation, what Swamiji has said. Therefore, it is our collective duty of all the citizens, all the stakeholders, all the societies, all the NGOs to celebrate 150th birth anniversary of Swami Vivekananda in a grand manner. So this kind of press conference we may need more and more. So whenever I call and whenever I request all the media and press people to, you know, attend the press conference, I would request that kindly cooperate with us so that we all together can spread the message and make this celebration a grand success. So before I, you know, give my own sense, I would request that any clarification is to be sought from the members of the core committee. Kindly, you can ask any kind of question, any clarification. Is there any doubt about this the celebration? Any points to be raised or any this thing, information you need, you can just ask before we wind up the conference, press conference. Thank you. Nothing to be asked, and now I would request my assistant publicity secretary, organizing committee, Mr. Sharma, to give what of things.
Yakji, Namam Akum sir, Director Higher and Technical Education, Dr. Joram Begi sir, Prinsin Dorji sir, Kadu sir, Director of IPR, Mere Secretary, Prachar समिति के सेक्रेटरी और मैं उनका डिप्टी हूँ। प्रेस के भाइयों बहनों, विवेकानंद केंद्र के आयोजकों, मेरे लिए बहुत ही खुशी की बात है दो तरह से। एक तो यह है कि जब ये विवेकानंद केंद्र तिनसुकिया में मैं था तो वहां मैं प्रेस का भी काम करता था, क्योंकि मैं डिप्लोमा था पत्रकारिता में, तो मैं सोचा मैं भी अपना तो पूर्वांचल प्रहरी और सेंटिनल में मैं लिखता था। मुझे याद है उस समय भी कोई समारोह इस तरह का चल रहा था, हमने अपने हर तरह के हर एक्टिविटी में और हर जगह स्वामी जी की कुछ बातों को कोट करने के लिए अभ्यास किया था, और स्कूल में भी हम लोगों ने इस तरह का प्रयास किया था। एक चीज जो बहुत ही क्लियर है कि जो स्वामी जी को पढ़ेगा जीवन में कभी उदास नहीं रहेगा। मैं दिल्ली में और डॉन बॉस्को या और किसी कॉलेज में बात करता हूँ बच्चों से जब इंस्पायर करने के लिए, तो उन बच्चों को कहता हूँ कि आज बच्चों में सुसाइडल टेंडेंसी बहुत बढ़ रही है, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया भी परेशान है,
मैं बताया उनको कि स्वामी जी की एक कोई किताब लेके जिंदगी में पढ़ो, गीता पढ़ो, मेरी मैं चैलेंज करता हूं कभी जिंदगी में सुसाइड नहीं कर सकते। बच्चों को बचाना है, युवा को बचाना है, स्वामी जी के पास लाना ही पड़ेगा अगर किसी को बचाना है तो। मित्रों, आप समाज के नेत्र हैं, आप समाज के प्रहरी हैं, आप अपने दृष्टि से समाज को दिखाइए स्वामी जी को, आप अपनी दृष्टिकोण से स्वामी जी को रेखांकित कीजिए। जरूरी नहीं कि जो प्रेस रिलीज में है आप वो दें। मेरा ये सजेशन रहेगा कि आप अपनी लेखनी में स्वामी जी को कहीं ना कहीं पिरोइए, देखिए आपकी भी प्रतिभा चमकेगी। आज के इस समारोह में प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस के जो अध्यक्ष हैं, व्यस्ततम व्यक्ति हैं आज अरुणाचल के। बेगी सर को क्या पूछ रहे, जब से अमेरिका से आए उनका जेट लैग खत्म नहीं हो रहा, लोग छोड़ते नहीं है। पाजू सर भी व्यस्तता बढ़ती जा रही है। रंजीत दोरजी सर अपने ही कार्यों में, समाज के कार्यों में लगे हुए हैं। केंद्र के लोगों ने इन लोगों को इसलिए यहां पुकारा कि विवेकानंद केंद्र का काम अरुणाचल में पूरे नॉर्थ ईस्ट से सबसे ज्यादा है। 35 स्कूल नॉर्थ ईस्ट के देश में किसी भी प्रदेश में नहीं है, 35 स्कूल और वन ऑफ द बेस्ट स्कूल्स। बालबाड़ी और जो अपने समाज कार्यों में लगे हुए लोग, लाइफ वर्कर्स, हमको याद है बेगी सर ने एक जगह कोट किया था कि बालकृष्णन जी जब इस केंद्र के जनरल सेक्रेटरी थे, इस प्रदेश को एक एक इंच उन्होंने नापा है। रहते हुए कन्याकुमारी, रहने वाले केरल के, डेडिकेशन है अरुणाचल के लिए। इतना डेडिकेशन क्यों, डेडिकेशन देखने से दूसरे लोग डेडिकेटेड होते हैं। रुपेश जी, ऐसे ऐसे लोग, कितने लोग अपना घर द्वार, पढ़ाई लिखाई, परिवार, किसको प्यारा नहीं है अपना परिवार, वो परिवार छोड़कर आकर अरुणाचल के सेवा में लग गए। अरुणाचल की सेवा इस तरह से कि यहां का एक एक बच्चा, एक एक सिटीजन आगे बढ़े। विवेकानंद न बने, बन जाए तो और अच्छा, न बने उनके रास्ते पर चल के इस समाज की सेवा करें। मुझे याद है एक समाज में एक वर्कशॉप कराया था, उसमें हुआ कि डॉक्टर बनना चाहते यहाँ के बच्चे, और यहाँ के बच्चों ने कहा कि मैं डॉक्टर बन के यहाँ सेवा नहीं करना चाहता। फिर केंद्र के लोगों ने झकझोरा, तुम अपने समाज की सेवा नहीं करना चाहते, मत बनो डॉक्टर। अनिनी झगला की बिथो हवाई कौन सेवा करेगा, पूना से, महाराष्ट्र, दिल्ली, बॉम्बे, कलकत्ता से लोग आएंगे। नहीं मित्रों, उनको जागृत करने की जरूरत है, जगाने की जरूरत है, विकप भारत जगाने की जरूरत है। मैं अपने पत्रकार भाइयों बहनों से अनुरोध करूंगा, किसी ने कहा प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस क्या, कोई सेमिनार क्या, वर्कशॉप क्या, पत्रकार नहीं तो बेकार है। आपको इसलिए मैं अनुरोध करूंगा कि इसको आज ही नहीं, जब कभी मौका मिले अपने नजर से देखिए, पूरे साल देखते रहिए, मजा आएगा। मैं एक जो देखता हूं उसको एक बोलता हूं। स्वामी जी का एक कोटेशन हर जगह मैं कोट करता हूं, गौरवपूर्वक उच्च स्वर से उद्घोष कर, प्रत्येक भारतवासी भारत का हरदेक भारतवासी भाई है, भारत की देवी देवता ईश्वर है, भारतवर्ष के समाज मेरे बचपन का झूला, यौवन की फुलवारी और बुढ़ापे की काशी है। कह भाई कह, भारत के कल्याण में ही कल्याण है, भारत के ही कल्याण में कल्याण है। स्वामी जी की एक एक बात समाज को जगाता है। प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस में सेक्रेटरी भाइयों बहनों, आयोजकों, अध्यक्ष महोदय और पूरे लोग, मैं उनको किस दृष्टि से, कितने अपने मन से धन्यवाद दूं जिन्होंने इस कार्यक्रम को अपनी उपस्थिति से जागृत किया और समाज को जगाने के लिए पीड़ा उठाया है और समाज को आगे बढ़ाने के लिए पीड़ा उठाया है। मैं धन्यवाद देता हूं अपने दिल से, केंद्र की तरफ से, अपनी तरफ से, अपनी कमेटी की तरफ से, आप सबको और मंच पर बैठे हुए सभी लोगों को कि आप इसको अपनी दृष्टि से देखिए। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।